All right, join now on the Sports Wrap to break down that Celtics loss with Kevin McNamara. Kevin, obviously a disastrous third quarter. They got close in the fourth, but was it coaching? Was it hustle? Was it just shot making? What was the downfall of the Celtics tonight?
Well, you know, it's interesting, Yanni. You bring up the coaching right off the top. Eric Spoelstra has done an unbelievable job throughout the entire playoffs. They only have one, Miami only has one defeat the entire bubble experience down there, but the switch to the zone defense, you don't see a lot of heavy zone in the NBA, really stifled the Celtics, and especially Jason Tatum, who's obviously been had a great scoring run through the playoffs. He only attempted 12 shots, and there was no question that that zone was specifically to slow down Jason Tatum. They did an excellent job.
Second straight game that the Celtics have a big lead and blow it. Do you think there's a complacency involved? What happened in the third quarter that Miami was able to outscore him by 20 points?
I saw them get tired. I thought Kemba Walker get tired. Kemba was outstanding in the first half. Huge bounce back game for him. All the credit in the world. In the third quarter, he was continually beat on defense. Miami does an excellent job isolating certain mismatches. They really pick on Kemba Walker, and they really pick on the pick and roll with the big guy. The Celtics have not had a big guy, a legit big-time big guy for multiple years now, and Bam Adebayo is really taking advantage of that mismatch.
So Bam was obviously a key factor there in the third quarter, seemingly making all their shots, all their roll guides, and then crunch time, you saw Jimmy Butler have a couple huge plays, that defensive play where he went down and scored on the other end. Usually Celtic teams under Brad Stevens aren't out-gritted, so to speak, but it feels like that's been the case, right?
No, and you know, you got, again, just tip your hat to Miami. Jimmy Butler is one of the toughest players in the league, and he came up with one big-time play at both ends of the court, really in the last two games. You know, he had a game-winning shot in game one, and then defensively here in the fourth quarter in game two, he's outplayed everyone else on the Celtics, including Tatum and Jaylen Brown.
All right, if this was normal circumstances, they'd be going to Miami now down 0-2. Obviously, they're in the bubble, so the momentum swings with home court aren't there. Do you see the Celtics rallying and making this a series? We saw a team like Denver come down from 3-1, so it's not impossible, but being down 2-0, a tough hill to climb.
Well, there's no question there's a huge benefit not being in the real world and getting on a plane and flying to Miami. I do think that if they can come back and win game three, it changes the series. I think this should be a six-game series, maybe a seven-game series. These two games have both come down to the last minute. First one, obviously, in overtime, very evenly matched. That said, Boston needs to play a full game. They have not played a full game at all. Their third quarters have been disastrous. I think Brad Stevens tried to make some adjustments in the first half with his rotations. In the second half, those same adjustments didn't pan out well at all. Kanter and Wanamaker specifically, they gave him a little bit in the first half, nothing in the second half. And Tatum was not Jason Tatum tonight, really because of Miami's zone defense.
Last one, obviously Tatum wasn't great down the stretch. Kemba was good early, but does it feel like Jaylen Brown's been too quiet recently?
Well, I think we've talked about this throughout the entire playoffs, Yanni. We've said that when Kemba, Tatum, and Jaylen Brown are all good, that's when Boston's dangerous and can be a finals-type team. I really believe that. In this series, the three of them have not played well at the same time. It's almost as if they're not sharing the ball well as a team with those three players. Those are their three best guys. They have to be able to function at a high level together. That hasn't happened in these first two games.
All right, good stuff from Kevin McNamara breaking down the Celtics and Heat game two. Thanks so much, Kevin. We'll have much more from the Sports Wrap, including some U.S. Open golf right after this.